Hey guys, it's Dave from Mind Your Bushcraft. Today we're having another fire in the backyard. See here. In the fire pit. And today's fire is not just for funsies. Today's fire has a purpose. The purpose of today's fire is that we're going to be making some pine resin. We're going to be making glue out of pine sap. And in order to do this, we need some charcoal. And we also need to heat up pine resin so that we can mix the charcoal into it. We're going to wait till this fire burns down a little bit. And it's just some hot embers. And we're going to use some charcoal. And we're going to grind that up. And once this fire gets down, I'll get back to you. Hey guys. Alright, so pine sap. We're going to be making some pine glue out of the pine sap, and the way you get to do that is by getting some pine sap, which we grabbed from that tree on our last little adventure, the last video I made, and you grab some charcoal, and you want to grind the charcoal. The secret recipe for this is about 5 parts pine sap to 3 parts charcoal. You can also, some of the guys will add in some droppings from any green leaf eating animal, rabbits, deer, so on and so forth. Any animal that eats greens, you can get their droppings, and you can add like 1 part droppings to this mixture. But it's not a necessity. You don't have to have that in order for this to work. So we're just gonna grind up this charcoal here, and just make it into a kind of a powder. Just gonna break it up here. Go ahead. Grind this up. What I'm using to grind it up in is just a an end cap for pipe. You can see it there. It's just an end cap. See the threading? So these actually these are pretty good for grinding things up, and like we're doing today, and for melting. What was the last thing? The last thing I melted in here was some silver, actually. So they're pretty good for just about anything. But let's grind this up. The fire is just about ready. And we could do this, you don't have to do this on a fire. I just thought I'd try to heat it up on the fire and do as much as I could outside instead of in the shop, just to show that that it can be done over a fire, like out in the woods. So and I mean, who doesn't like to play by the fire anyway? And just try and do this without getting burnt today. Alright, well, I'm gonna finish grinding this up, and shouldn't take me any more than a few more minutes, and I'll get back to you. So I was just thinking about how you would do this in the woods, and essentially I think that the best way to do it would be to carve yourself out a bowl, kind of like you would a spoon, except make it a little deeper, a little bigger. So carve yourself out a bowl out of a piece of wood, and then get yourself a stick about half an inch wide in diameter, kind of like this,
Oops. And then make one end flat. And that seems to work. That seems to work pretty good for grinding this up. You can see that it's pretty well done now. But so you just grind that up in a bowl made of wood with essentially a half inch piece of dowel that you can make out of any stick. So, all right. Well, this is essentially done. And I think we're gonna take this outside, and we're gonna take the sap outside and get this rolling. I'll meet you out there.
All right, so see if I can zoom in here. We got the pine sap on the fire. You can see it's already starting to bubble and heat up. I literally just put that on there maybe, I don't know, 5 seconds ago. So you can see there's no flames, it's just ash and coals. So it's still fairly hot though. So we're just gonna take a stick or, sorry, whatever you wanna use, and just kinda stir it about. Now, some guys will tell you that you need to filter this. You probably should filter it if there's any like large chunks of wood. Or anything else of the sort that's in it. Some guys will filter it by putting it in a cylinder-like can and puncturing holes in the bottom, and then putting another can underneath to catch it, so that when it heats up and it starts turning into a liquid form, just the liquid will flow into the can that's underneath, and the rest of the garbage will stay on top. We're not going to get that detailed today. We're just going to kind of simulate being out in the woods and you know, not having a whole lot to do this with. Oh, that's really it's really hot. Find ourselves a bigger stick. I can't get my hand in there, it's too hot. All right. There we go. So I want to heat that up until it, you know, it's completely liquid. Oh. Essentially, it's liquid form here. So, you want to be careful with that too. Like I said, this stuff is extremely flammable. So now we're just going to take our grinded up charcoal, take our grinded up charcoal, and we're just going to mix it in there while we're kind of stirring it. Try not to get in the way here. Well, you guys can see how flammable this stuff really is. That's why it's great for fire starting. So you just want to mix that in.
in really well. And then we're going to pull this off the fire. Together.
So we'll come down here beside the fire pit. We got it out of the fire now. We're just gonna keep stirring it. Mixed in there really well. Smoke got in my eyes. Other uses for this stuff, other than glue, is for waterproofing articles of clothing. You can use this stuff, waterproof your boots, your tent, you can use it for patching. It's all sorts of uses. It's I don't know, pine resin is fantastic, in my opinion anyway. Keep stirring this stuff in, and as it cools down, or when it starts to cool down enough that we can start playing with it, I'll get back to you. All right, guys. See if we can zoom back. Oops. Zoom back out here. It's cooled down enough that I can actually touch it. Oh, that's awesome. Let's get this grass out of here. And leave. And what we'll do is we're going to start to pick this stuff up, and you can actually start to shape it onto the stick here. And oops. All right, let's try to scrape as much of this up as we can. Basically what you want to do is you want to try to shape it around something like this, a stick or whatever else you want to use. And as it cools, oh, this is pretty hard now. Oh. As it cools, it's going to get harder and harder. Be careful because it cools fast. But you can see how hard it is. Whatever you apply it to, it's going to waterproof it, or it's going to glue it into place. But essentially, keep it on something like this. And when you need to apply it, all you have to do is heat it back up. Now we can throw this can back on the fire, heat what's in there back up again, and add it to the stick. Or you could heat the stick back up and you could apply it to whatever you need to apply it to, whether you be attaching, I've seen guys attach ferrule rods into handles that they have made themselves. You can attach a rock that you've made into a spear, into a stick, so on and so forth. Whatever you could possibly think up, you can use this stuff to glue it into place or to waterproof it. It's quite awesome, to be honest with you. For something that you get out of the woods. Get back to you in a minute, because there's one other application that I want to try that I haven't done yet, but I need the stuff to be a little cooled down. This is my first attempt at this, so I have no idea whether it's gonna work or not. I know you have no idea what I'm doing, but you will in a second. Here is a makeshift arrowhead made out of pine resin. We'll see whether or not you're saying that. Go on this side, the smoke is just killing me here. It
some flames going. Less smoke. You can see how this stuff is so pliable. You can play with it, heat it up, play with it some more, heat it up, until you get the right shape that you're looking for. You get it glued on. Now, even if this works, an arrowhead like this is probably a one-time use, but you made it out of pine sap, out of a tree that's easily accessible and easily found. Continue to heat it up and continue to shape it. I mean, the limits to this pine sap is basically your imagination. I think that's good. It's good for now, good for a test anyway. So let's let this cool down and grab the bow and let this baby fly. See if she can pierce the box. All right, I'll see you in a minute. All right, so we got our bow. And see if you can see it. There's a box. And we got our makeshift pine sap, pine tar arrow. I haven't shot my bow in a while, so let's see if we can actually hit the box.
So you can see here the arrowhead. See if you can see it. The sun's out now. It's difficult to see anything, but you can see here it chipped at the very top, pierced the box. I'm about, I don't know, 10 meters away. Went through the box both sides, and it just kind of chipped the arrowhead, the top of it. But like I said, this is probably a one-time use. I just thought it'd be something cool to try with the pine sap, other than glue and waterproofing. But I guess the limits to it would be your imagination. So it'd be cool to hear from you guys if you've done any other experiments or any other things with pine sap, the pine resin after it's been transformed into this sticky, gluey substance. If you have, let me know. That would be awesome. So, anyway, I hope this video was informative. I hope you learned something new. And I look forward to hearing your comments. If you like this video and you did learn something, give it a thumbs up. If not, just leave a comment. All right. We'll talk to you guys later. This is Dave from Mind Your Bushcraft. And I'll see you on my next video. Hey, guys. Just a quick note, I used a stone and kind of sharpened the end of it, the tip that had broken off. I've used it a couple more times in the box and it's still intact, so I don't know, just thought I'd let you guys know. Pretty cool. Thanks for watching.